There's a whole lot of talk out there about refugees, who should take them in, who should not. But let's back up and simply define who a refugee is. It is a person who has been forced to leave their country in order to escape war, persecution, or natural disaster. Those are not things most natural-born Americans know well firsthand. So let's for a minute think about who refugees are by definition, like I just mentioned. And then let's listen to one who has a dream.
Mohammed Malim's inspiration to tell the stories of refugees was rooted in a frustrating truth. He was tired of how those stories were being told.
There's a lot of media outlets over there, you know, who portrays refugees in a bad way, in a negative way. And it's my duty to tell my own story and my own people's stories, you know, as a refugee perspective.
Before we get to how he's doing that, Mohammed's story is one hundreds of thousands of Somali families can sadly tell.
I am a former refugee from Somalia. I came to America to have a better life, me and my family. We fled from a civil war back during the 1990s.
He was 3 years old when his family won a lottery out of a refugee camp in Kenya, a camp his mother tells him was one in which she had to fight to keep he and his brother alive.
It was tough because she had to sleep with cockroaches, you know, snakes in those camps, and she had to sacrifice every night to find food for us, you know, and for my little brother.
His mother survived and made it here, to this land of the free. And ever since, Mohammed has thrived.
Having this opportunity and privilege and growing up in America is absolutely amazing, because I am the first in my family to graduate from high school and almost there to graduate from senior in college.
Graduate he will next spring, but beyond his degree was his drive, as I said, to tell his story and refugee stories. That telling is called the Dream Refugee Project.
And with everything that's going on with our current political climate, we tell successful refugee around the local community, and just to break the xenophobic, just breaking that decisive hatred towards our community, and just want to reconnect the broader community through the refugees.
With words and pictures, Mohammed is giving the refugees of our community a voice to tell their stories in their own words, how they came here, how they overcome here. Always with a simple thread, that we are far more alike than we are different.
That's the beauty part about being a refugee, because it all comes from a different background, different ethnicity, and different color, you know? At the same time, we all have a common goal to make our family and to have a better life in a new country, you know?
It's just that simple, and it was simply, in his opinion, not being done, telling that truth. A truth like his, born from an origin story of coming to America against all odds.
We came here, we contributed to society, and look at us now. Like, we contribute a lot to this great country, you know?
What's your one wish for this country?
Love, I'll say. Love and unity. I want everyone from different ethnicity, different background to come together and just celebrate the gift of life.
I can't encourage you enough to check out his website, dreamrefugee.org. It's really beautiful. It's also on Instagram, and all it is are portraits. You saw some of the people in there, people in our community who are refugees telling the stories of who they are. And I want to add, if Mohammed's mother is watching, her dream was to see her son graduate from college. He will be the first in his family to do so. That will happen this spring. He's majoring in marketing at St. Thomas. Again, it's dreamrefugee.org. Check it out.
Cool. I can't imagine being his mom or his parents or relatives, knowing the sacrifices that they made and then seeing the results from those sacrifices. It must be a wonderful feeling.
Yeah, it is, and he's a positive person doing positive change in this community. And one of the things that fascinated me about Mohammed is that so many terrible things are said about people like him. And I asked if that bothered him or made him angry, and he said he doesn't have time to think about that. Too much good to do.
I'm too focused.
We could learn from that.